गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स स्टूडेंट्स इन आईपी वी वर डूइंग चैप्टर 3 पाइथन फंडामेंटल्स एक्सरसाइज वी वर डूइंग सो इन दैट आई हैव ऑलरेडी टेकन टू पार्ट्स नाउ दिस इज पार्ट 3 ऑफ एक्सरसाइज सो जस्ट गेट रेडी विद योर पेपर बुक पेन सो दैट वी कैन डू द एक्सरसाइज Now questions up to fourth question we have already done in this. Now we are on question number 5. Question is what is the problem with the following code fragments? So here a code is given. We have to find out like what is wrong in that code. So let's do it in Python only so that we could understand it in a better way. Here A equals to 3 is written then print A. But it's There is problem in the code, so we will check that in Python only. So I am starting Python first of all. I am opening Python for you. Python 3.9 version. Now we have come on the interactive mode. Now I will open script mode only. Okay, new file I am taking from here, and here I will take my practice file. Open. Now this has been opened. This is the question that we did last time. So I'm just erasing the code and typing the code that we need to do right now. Code is print A. It was let's check it once more. What was the code? Just do minimize it and check it over there. Code is A equals to 3 then print A. So we have to do this. So here I'm typing A equals to 3. A equals to 3. Then we are writing print A. So it's not showing. Let's run it. F5 I am using for running. Showing. So there is no problem with the code. Okay, so we have checked that there is no problem with the code. Now we will see next part. Here A equals to 3, print A, no problem with this much. Then B equals to 4, print B. We will see that. Now print in the same program we are writing B equals to 4. Then print B. This I have written. Now I will execute it again. Now this is showing B also. B is also displayed on the screen. Now this much is OK. It means then S equals to A plus B and print S. So we will do that now. S equals to A plus B. Then print S. So it's showing the sum. Okay. So as such, there is no problem with the code. It has been asked what is the problem with the following code fragment. So there is no problem in this code. Only the problem is like we can make it more presentable by writing sum equals to s. Okay, otherwise there is no problem in the code. Now we will do the next part, which is name. One value is written in that, then age is given, then print your name and age are name plus age. Okay, so let's see. First we need to write name, then age. So here only I'm typing name, whose name I have taken Pratika. Okay, then age I have taken 26. Then what was next in that? Print your name and age are name plus age. So I'll do that. Print, we are writing print statement, print your name and age. It was in this way, then comma was there, then we were showing name plus age. So we were writing in this way, name plus age. Okay, let's do control S and run it. Now there is some problem with the okay name equals to here we have input control S F5. Can only concatenate string, not into star. Now there is problem in this program. You can see over here what mistake is coming. Can only concatenate. Concatenate means add string, not int. Means you can concat two values which are having string value. You cannot concatenate two values which are having string or integer. Here, this Pratika, it's a string value, you can see it. And this age 26, it's a integer value. So we cannot concatenate. This is the problem in this code. Okay. So we can solve this problem by making it string. And how we can make a integer string? We can make a integer string by how we can make it a integer string just by adding quotation marks in this. So I have put quotation marks here. Okay. Now quotation marks, after putting quotation marks, we will see whether it's working or not. Let's run it. See, now it's working. Your name and age Pratika 26. How it came? Because when there are two strings, then if we are using this plus operator, what it will do, it will show them at one place, or it will concat them, it will join them. So that's why Pratika 26 is coming. That's why it's coming in this way, Pratika 26. Okay students, I hope you got what was the problem in the code and what we have just done. Problem was that it was an integer value. Okay, and what we were doing, we were trying to concat one integer and one string value. So we cannot concat it in that way. So just to make it correct, what we did, we just made that integer value string. And how we made that integer value string? Just by putting these double quotation symbols over here. Now it has become a string. Now if we will use plus operator between these two, then these both strings will be displayed together. Okay students, now we are moving to the next question or the next part of the question. Next part of the question is a equals to 3, s equals to a plus 10. So s will become 3 plus 10, 13. Now a equals to new. Now what we have done, we have assigned value new inside a. What is this new? New is a string value. It's a string value. We can make it out from the quotation marks. Now what we are doing inside Q, we are dividing A by 10. So will it work? No, it will not work because now A contains value new and new is a string. You cannot do division on a string value. Okay students, so let's type and do solve it. We'll just check it in Python whether it's working or not. Student, these kind of questions will come in exam. And they are really important for understanding the basic concepts of this Python language. Okay, students. So now we are typing this code, third part. I have deleted this. Now I have written a equals to 3. Then we were doing s equals to a plus 10. Till now it's okay. After that, what we did, we assigned value new inside A. Okay, it was the question. Let's check question again here. New has been assigned. Now what we are doing, Q equals to A upon 10. So Q equals to A upon 10. We will write here Q equals to A upon 10. Now, what will happen? What we are trying to do? We are trying to divide value of a by 10. Here, value of a has been changed. Okay, so this is a mistake. Let's see. See, error has come. Type error, unsupported operand type for str and int means unsupported str and int, they cannot work in this way. Okay, that's why this error comes in. How we can solve this problem? If we make this the comment entry, now what will happen? Since I have made this line comment entry, what will happen? This line will not get executed. So since this line is not getting executed, now the value inside A is 3 only. Now what we are doing? 3 upon 10. So that should work because A is an integer and 10 is also integer. Now the operator is working on both integer values, so it should work because this division, it works on integer values. Okay, so let's check it. See, output is not coming. Why? No error is coming, no output is coming. Error is not there, output is not coming because we haven't used the print statement. Okay, so if I'll write here print q, only then answer will be printed. Now I have written print q. See, now 0.3 answer is coming. Now this code is correct, otherwise this code was having problem. How like what was the problem? Problem was this, like we assigned a string value inside A, and after that what we did, we were dividing that string value with 10, so which is not possible. We cannot divide a string with an integer value. That was the problem with the code. How we solved that? We have just made it a comment entry, or we can say we can just delete this line, then we can solve this problem. Okay, or we can assign a new integer value also inside A. Suppose if in place of new I will assign here 30, then also it will work, then it also corrected. Let's run it. See, then now value 3 is coming because now 30 is divided by 10, which is correct, means we can divide an integer with an integer. So this was the problem in this code that we have just seen. Okay, now we have done these three parts, first part, second part, third part. First part was okay, there was no problem in this. Okay, and then there was problem, what we were trying to do, we were concatenating one integer and one string value, which is not possible. Then in this part, what we were doing, we were dividing a string by a integer value, so that is also not possible. That was the problem in the code. Okay, now next question is about predicting the output. Okay, so what will be the output? Let's understand it here only, then we will do it in the Python. Here x is a variable. Now x equals to 40 and y equals to x plus 1. So what will become inside y now? Y equals to x plus 1 means 40 plus 1, 41 will become. Now x equals to 20. Now new value has been given in x, which is 20, and y plus x means whatever was there inside y, we have added x inside that. So here inside y it was 41, and now 41 plus what is the value inside x? 20. So 41 plus 20, it should be 61. Okay, so the answer should be in this way, like 20 61. Let's check the output whether it is coming in that way or not. Okay student, so let's type this code in the Python. x equals to 40, y equals to x plus 1. We will type that. First we need to erase this previous code. X equals to 40, y equals to x plus 1. Okay, then what was next in that? It was x equals to 20 comma y plus x. X equals to 20 comma y plus x, it was there. Next, then what was there inside that? It was print xy. Okay, so let's write print xy, print x, comma y. Okay, now we will execute it. See, answer is coming 20, 81, 41. How this is coming? Let's check that. We are printing value of x, which is 40. Then inside x we assign value. Here y equals to x plus 1. Okay, students, wait for a while. X equals to 40, y equals to x plus 1, so it will become 41. Now here x equals to 20, comma y plus x. So here first we will print x. It will make us more clear about the code. Okay, students, here I am printing x just to understand the code in a better way. Means x equals to, I am giving x. So let's execute it. Then 20, 81 is coming and 41 is also coming. X ki value, it's 20 is coming over there. Again, I am showing you the output. X is coming, 20. Then x value is coming. Then 41, we calculated value of y, that is coming. Okay. Then what we have done, we have assigned inside. See, we did this kind of assignment also. Here what we are doing, 41 plus x. So x was 40 here earlier. So 41 plus 40, it has become 81. That's why it's showing 81. Let's execute it once more, students. It's coming 20, 81, then 20, 81, 41. Okay, now you got what will be the output in this case. Okay, 20, first 40, x value, then y value 41. Okay, then after that we are displaying y. Y is how much? Y is 41, so that's why 41 is coming. So 40, 41, and then 20, and here 81. That's why this output is coming. Let's 20, 81, 20, 81, 41. Okay, students. Now next is xy equals to 20, 60. Then what will be the output here? Y, x, y, what we have done, inside y we are giving value of x. Then inside x, we are giving value of y minus 10. And y equals to will be x plus 10. And here x equals to 20, y equals to 60. And print x, y, then we are doing. Okay. So let's do this code also in Python. We are coming in Python. Here I am writing again that code. X comma y equals to 20, 60, comma y equals to 20, 60. I'll show you the output here only so that you could understand it. Print x we will do, and print y also we will do. Okay, let's check it here only so that you could understand how this assignment is taking place. See, 20, 60, it means what value has come inside x? 20 has come. What value has come inside y? 60 has come. Okay, now I am making it comment entry, or we will write the code ahead. Comment entry means this part will not get executed. Now next line is y comma x comma y. Now y, comma x, comma y equals to what are the values? X, comma y minus 10, x, comma y minus 10, comma x plus 10, x plus 10. Okay, the next print x y. So here we will write print x y. Now students, let's see output. What should be the output? Here I have shown you, like when we are giving comma and doing assignment, what 20 value has come inside x and 60 value has come inside y. So here what we are doing, y equals to first value will come inside y. So what is first value? It's x. So what was there inside x? It was 20. So y should be 20 here. Okay, after that x equals to y equals to this is the value of x, value of x will come y minus 10. So whatever value of y was there, 10 will be deducted from that. Okay, I'll just do the print here so that you can understand it. I'm writing print. First, I'll show you the y, like what is there inside y. Let's execute it. 30 and 30 is coming inside y. How it's coming? Y equals to x we have done. And after that, x value is y minus 10. So now we will print here x. Print x. I'm making this line comment entry just to so that you can understand what has been assigned inside y, x, y. Okay. Now again here, control S, F5. See, 30 and 50. Two values has been printed. 30 for y has been printed. How 30 has come? How 30 has come inside y? Earlier it was 20. Now what we did here? We did y equals to x. So what was x earlier? It was 20 only. So the value 20 came here. Okay. Then what we did? Y equals to 20 minus 10. Okay, so the value of y changed. Again, what we did, 20 plus 10, so it became 30. That's why value of y, it's showing 30. Okay, students, see, when we are assigning values with commas, first value go inside first element, second value will go inside second element, and third value will go inside third element. That's why the output is coming in this way. Okay, now we will move to the next question. Next question is again of output. Here a comma b equals to 12, 13, then c comma b equals to a into 2, means what will come inside c? A multiply by 2. So a was 12 multiply by 2, 24. Then what will come inside b? 12 upon whatever is the value of a, that upon 2. So a was 12 upon 2, it will come 6. Okay, so let's see what is the answer. First we will type it in the Python. Here a comma b equals to 12 a comma b equals to 12 comma 13. So it means a is having 12 and b is having 13. After that we wrote c comma b equals to c comma b equals to a into 2 comma a upon 2. a into 2 comma b upon 2. Next, what we have written, print abc we are doing. Here print a comma b comma c. Okay, now let's execute it, then I will explain you. See, answer is coming 12 6.5 24. So how it is coming? Answer is coming 12 6.5 24. Okay, so here we will see, first of all, a value is 12, so that's why a's value is, a value is coming 12. Then b value, what is the value of b? Here initially b was assigned 13, but here what we are doing, c comma b equals to c, according to the question what we have done, c comma b. So here c will contain this a into 2, so a into 2, 24 will come inside c, and what will come inside b? It will come b upon 2. So b upon 2 means 13 upon 2. So 13 upon 2, it was 6.5. So that's why this answer is coming. Yes, that's why this answer is coming 12 6.5 24. Again I'm explaining, a equals to 12, then b equals to 13, then c equals to 12 into 2 24 has become. Now inside b value is changing. How it is changing? It has become b upon 2, so it will be 13 upon 2 6.5. So here that's why value is coming 12 6.5 24. Okay, again I'm showing you the output 12 6.5 24. This was the output of this. Okay students, now next last part, a comma b equals to 12 13, print a plus b. Let's see. So it is, I'll do correction in this only, a comma b, then print a plus b. Here one more print was there, a plus b, then bracket close it was. Okay, and one more bracket, control s f5. See, 25 and none. How this answer has come? 25 and none. First print statement, it's returning 25. Okay, 25. After that, since we are trying to return print 25, so that's why that value is not coming. Okay, that's why this answer is coming in this way. This was all in the exercise. These kind of questions you need to practice for your exam also, students. Now I'll start the revision from the next video. Thank you.